Ella. It's the Baka Awards. It's a one time for Baka. What do they have for us? What the fuck do they have for us? Why am I streaming this? This is so funny. This is really so funny for me. It's a funny little time for everyone, but it's especially funny for me. We got 1 minute to go, everyone. That's crazy. Baka! It's Baka Awards, yes! The Baka Awards! In 46 seconds! It's so crazy. It's a crazy fucking time. My audio will save. I have no- I think Resident Evil, maybe? Resident Evil. Genshin Impact, of course, but Resident Evil, I think is what I'm expecting. Oh god. We'll see how we go. We'll see how we go. Can I make the OBS louder? Sure. Is it a microphone? Microphone?
Oh, ooh! Me, Sydney Goodman, here to greet you all what I consider to be my favorite holiday of the season, the 2023 Game Awards. And just like New Year's Eve, our Game Awards opening act is as full of excitement and celebration as the big event. Tonight, the Game Awards will celebrate the best in gaming from the past year, and we've got more than a dozen new game announcements. Plus, the old gods of Asgard are here from Alan Wake 2. They take the stage. For the first time ever, it is truly magical here, live at the Peacock Theater for gaming's biggest night. Peacock? We are streaming around the world, connecting millions of gamers and fans, and getting you all stoked for our big show. But before that, it's time to get cozy with our very first world premiere of the night. Yes, let's hear it.
Ew.
It comes from a creator who has already claimed Game of the Year in the past here at TGA. But this time, we're going back to the title that started it all for him a decade ago. Here's the first ever look at a beautiful remake of Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons, originally created by director Joseph Ferris.
What's this? 505 days. Me neither. It looks cool. There's lots of giants. Very small.
Leia!
This is a remake. I've never heard of it. Who's that?
Incredible! No! And how perfect that right after the world premiere of Brothers, we have the award for Best Family Game. These are the games that bring families together or tear them apart, depending on how dirty you play. And the nominees are Disney Illusion Island, Party Animals, Pikmin 4, Sonic Superstars,
ooh,
and Super Mario Brothers Wonder.
I don't think Disney should have won.
Goes to
Party Animals.
Super Mario Brothers Wonder.
Yes! Pikmin, hello! Hello, Holy Midnight Belial, welcome!
Thank you so much for this award. This is shared with all the teams at Nintendo that worked on Super
Pikmin.
Mario Bros. Wonder. In my experience, the team really tried to develop a game that allowed people to work together, to play together, whether it was friends or it was family. And for me, my personal experience is, nothing brings a family together more than trying to rescue an empire, a kingdom in distress from the evil likes of Bowser. Whether you're playing as Elephant Mario, Peach, Yoshi, or Nabbit, this game goes to everyone that created such a wonderful experience. Thank you.
Congratulations, Super Mario Brothers Wonder. And now I have a little treat for all of you. 3 world premieres in a row. What?
What?
First up is the next game from Daniel Mullins, the creator of the TGA-nominated independent game, Inscription.
Inscription, okay. Let's take a look. It's got a USB. Crusty ass USB. Ew! It's good? This looks cool. It looks haunted as fuck there. It looks super haunted. Hey, what? That's a voice actor I know. That's Proz. Proz EXT. This is very experimental. I love it. That was a very cool trailer. What's this? Different aesthetic? Different look? That's a bit odd, 2 years. I would have thought it would have been released earlier. But maybe the beta's already out. Rise of the Golden Idol. Interesting. Trailer was a bit like defined. Holy Knight says defined good, and we've seen better trailers. Actually, this is sick. This is a sick trailer. Can she parry? That's the question. Can they parry? Oh, look at that. That combo. See, this is a trailer. This is a game trailer. 2025, again, 2 years.
I love this. Reminds me of my high school days, but the monsters I fought weren't nearly as big as that. You kids these days with your giant monsters and your social media. And speaking of social media, TikTok Live Fest is happening now across 50 plus countries on TikTok. Check out the participating gaming creators and don't forget to share all of your favorite gaming moments on TikTok with hashtag gaming on TikTok. Okay, we're going to take a quick break, but there is plenty more opening act after a very important message. Don't skip this cutscene, people.
The journey ended here. A place of wonder and awe. We breached the cosmic veil.
This is Arknights. And reached a Enfield. New planet. This is Arknights Enfield. Oh my god, yes.
Generations later.
Yes.
The world remains untamed.
Arknights Enfield, our fucking go. Let's go.
Our paths destined to cross. I'm here for you now, Administrator.
I've been waiting for this game to have more content out for a long time. And finally we're seeing something. I'm looking forward to this game being released. whoever wrote that joke for her, it just didn't land. It just didn't land. She was just like, I have to say this fuck. This is cool. Never seen this game before, but it looks nice. A world of uncertainty. Wacid moves. It's Arknights. Arknights is different. But I do want another Hoyoverse game. I do want to play another Hoyoverse game.
You are the chosen one.
It's by Bilibili. So it's a Chinese game. The rogue trader
has fallen.
Interesting.
Now I must take up their mantle to restore the dynasty to its former glory, to reclaim what humanity has lost, to venture forth into darkness and
this
bring
looks,
the light of the
good.
Emperor to the uncharted void.
Very cinematic trailer.
Heretics,
power
defense,
mutants, turn-based
game. Threats beyond number. All must be cleansed in his name. The choices I make will shape the course of my destiny. And with each haunted step, I wonder, where will my journey end?
Wait, you're Connor Kenway.
Good thing for you that I am here, then.
Today, you are to see a traitor to the crown, hanged by the neck. For his crime,
do you think they're just reskinning
the
classes? The
penalty is death.
I'm in search of a treasure. Where do I start?
Today on the canals with my good friend Ezio. What could be better?
Flatter me as always, Antonio.
Is this Assassin's Creed?
Will succeed.
It's Assassin's Creed, right?
A triumph, Android Central.
It looks like Assassin's Creed something. Yeah.
Assassin's Creed Nexus.
So it's. Oh, it's virtual
reality.
Welcome
back to the 2023 Game Awards opening act. I'm still Sydney Goodman, here with
Hello,
another
Sydney.
Award, this time for innovation and accessibility. The gaming community is massive, but honestly, it should be even bigger. And these nominees are pushing gaming beyond its current limits. Their teams have created software and hardware that make it possible for people of all abilities to experience the medium of gaming. with accessible features and technology that get us all one step closer to a seamless play for everyone. These nominees are doing the work, and they are Diablo 4, Forza Motorsport, Hi-Fi Rush, Marvel's Spider-Man 2, Mortal Kombat 1, and Street Fighter 6.
Interesting, interesting selection.
And the Game Award goes to Forza Motorsport.
What? What? Well, I've never heard of that game before. Let's go. Forza Motorsport. I know
so
about Street Fighter 6.
Since this category was introduced several years ago, I think we've seen a dramatic shift in the whole industry towards making games more and more accessible. And with this list of amazing nominees, it just really drives that home. At this point, I think we've made the most accessible racing game ever playable by people across the mobility and vision spectrum, including totally blind players. But really, the real winners here are the players who have so many great games to play.
It's a heavy award.
None of this would have been possible without the amazing teams behind the scenes. Big thank you to our audio team for their tireless effort, championing for accessibility, and making this game the best that it can be. Big thank you to the UI team, to our studio leadership team, and our accessibility leadership team. And last but not least, Brandon Cole for being our accessibility consultant and partner for the last 2 years. We're really proud of the work that we've been able to do, so thank you very much.
I'll have to check it out. I'll have to check the game out for myself. To check the game out, because I've never heard of it.
Congratulations, Forza Motorsport. Here at the Game Awards, we believe strongly in accessibility and want to celebrate any game that makes it a priority. And our next developer, The Odd Gentleman, believe that by making their games and their company accessible and inclusive, they can develop new types of gameplay with stories that everyone can enjoy. They created the following game in a deep collaboration with artists and developers from the deaf community, and we are very excited to reveal it now. This is Harmonium the Musical.
The musical? Oh, wait. This is a musical? I've never heard of this. So many games I haven't heard of. It's rare to see music in musicals in games. Okay, she's getting warped.
Look around me. There's music everywhere.
This is Disney. Let's fucking go. This is Disney. this is a Disney sensation. Harmonium, I've got the musical. See, I'm not a fan of musicals because I was a stage manager at some point in musical theater. But I respect
Honestly,
it.
I don't know how much better gaming can get. What happens past a golden age? Platinum? Is this the platinum age of gaming? Also, can I please be paid in platinum? I'd like a direct deposit, please. And now I have the honor of announcing the winners for our 5 esports categories.
Baka.
The nominees for best esports athlete are Faker, Zywoo, Demon One.
Wait,
Hydra,
there's esport athlete
Ruler,
nominations?
And Imperial Howe. And
anyone?
The Game Award goes to...
We know anyone?
Faker!
I have no idea who that is. Faker,
for
good
best
job.
Esports coach, the nominees are Potter, Zonic, Gunba, Ecstasy, and Homie. And the Game Award goes to... Potter! For best esports event, here are the nominees.
Okay, esports
2023
event.
League of Legends World Championship.
Me neither.
Last TV Players Major 2023.
Dota 2 Championships. Let's go, Dota.
Dota 2 Championships 2023 and Valorant Champions 2023. And the game award goes to 2023 League of Legends World
League of Legends. I would have thought Valorant would have smashed
game,
that.
The nominees are Counter-Strike 2, Dota 2,
PUBG,
League of Legends, PUBG Mobile.
I think it's Valorant.
And the game award goes to Valorant.
Valorant. Yes, I was right.
And finally, the nominees for Best Esports Team are Evil Geniuses, Fnatic, Gaming Gladiators, JD Gaming, and Team Vitality. And the game award goes to JD Gaming.
I have
huge
no idea who these
are. I love esports. I'm a huge esports fan, just like my father and his father before him. We Goodmans are a huge esports family, dating all the way back to the mid-1800s. But before you can think too hard on that, it's time for another two world premieres. First up is the latest game from a team that won at the Game Awards back in 2017. So I think we can trust them to crush it again. This is Windblown.
Oh, this looks cool. It looks very cool. They nailed it. They nailed the anime aesthetic. The early 2000s. Okay. Oh, it's gory. Okay. Dead Cells. Ooh, look at that! We've got a golem shooting a laser beam. Oh god, the gore! Getting murdered out there. What's happening? Cool trailer though.
Oh, thank you, Meg.
Windblown. PC Early Access 2024. So this is coming soon on Steam. I love the aesthetic of this game. Bumper, let's go. Oh, what is this? This looks like a fever dream. Is this a rhythm game? It's giving me rhythm game vibes from a first look at it. The biker would have bikified. Game Awards. This looks like a bad, like a, not like a, like a trip. It looks like a DMT trip visuals. Like a bad DMT trip visual. Okay, there's a baby.
Thrasher.
That, not sure what game that is.
Yes. Thrasher, in case you didn't know, is from the same artist slash composer that blew our minds back in 2016 with the cult hit Thumper. I'm so excited we've got another mind-bending game coming from him in 2024. Special shout out to Samsung and Samsung Gaming Hub, who, not to brag, Samsung? Are also throwing a massive Game Awards viewing party over at Samsung's New York City flagship location with Typical Gamer and Chica. I wish I could be at two places at once, but the last time I tried to clone myself, I sparked a pretty sizable fire in the MIT experimental physics lab. Oops, but we can talk about that later. Let's check out what Samsung is coming out with now.
Yeah, it's more visuals. Like, it was more of like a visual trailer than like an actual gameplay trailer. Or what is Samsung doing to the gaming industry? We'll find out. This is very interesting. It's more like a...
You in? Like, we've seen some trailers where, like, you actually see the gameplay, or you see the narrative or the story. At least show us the story, I think. There's a lot of cool things coming out of Korea in terms of technology. This is gonna be interesting.
Sewing is my life.
Sorry!
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Sewing is my life.
Sewing is my life. So this is Persona. It's another Persona game.
That's the Dark Hour. A time period hidden between one day and the next.
They only appear during the Dark Hour and attack anyone who roams free outside the coffin.
Genshin Dating Simulator. Got it.
To defeat them. Pretty exciting, huh?
Persona.
I've never played any of the Persona games.
Why do you try to fight when you know it's hopeless?
In fact, I don't even really have a good reason to live. For me, or you, or anyone, just simply existing gives our lives meaning. Soon, the end will come.
We are not giving up, no matter how long it takes! To me, this is what it means to live.
So, P3 Persona Reload. Interesting. 2024. I've never played any of them.
Yes, so I was hoping for a new Persona.
To see what
a new Persona
about.
Game, that is. I still want to be Sydney. But enough about me. Make sure to stay tuned as Google and the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 5 are bringing you a spectacular celebration of mobile gaming. It's going to be an epic event, just like this next world premiere. It's the product of a surprise team up between two nominated games tonight. Let's check it out.
Okay, interesting. Gonna have a sip off in the green room. I think the writer, whoever wrote her script is, it's, Day of the Diver Dredge. Okay, so Nintendo Switch and Steam.
I can't believe it. It's almost time for our big show. The theater is filling up behind me. It's hard to hear myself think over all the excitement, but I have to keep it together because I have the next award ready to go. Here are your nominees for Content Creator of the Year.
Content Creator of the Year?
People Make Games, Quackity, Spring, and...
I am Mouse. I am Mouse. VTuber.
The Game Award goes to... Iron Mouse.
Yes!
So, Iron Mouse couldn't be here tonight because Iron Mouse is animated, and sadly, we're not in the Matrix yet. But she did send us a message. Take it away, Iron Mouse.
I am so incredibly honored to have been the recipient of the Content Creator of the Year Award. First and foremost, I want to express my deepest heartfelt gratitude to the incredible community that has gathered around my streams. And I also want to extend a very special thanks to Vishojo, who brings all my ideas to life. Thank you so much to my team that helps me every single day. And thank you so much to the Game Awards. I still can't believe this is all happening.
Yes, she's super.
Thank you again, everybody.
Like, she's one of the original Vishojo members.
Congratulations, Iron Mouse. Okay, we're getting so close to the big show, but I'm not ready to let go just yet. And no, I'm not a narcissist, I'm just a hoarder of world premieres. And up next is a very special world premiere, 15 years in the making.
15 years in the making, this must be an interesting game.
What a beautiful world.
Is this Salad Fingers?
They never made another one.
Giving me Salad Fingers vibes.
a platformer, I think. A weird platformer. That's another game I should play. It looks cool though.
World of Goo 2!
It's 2. So the sequel. So the sequel came out 15 years later.
Man,
holy shit.
That is satisfying to watch. Almost as satisfying as the Game Awards show that's minutes away. We have one more huge world premiere, a brand new fantasy RPG from the creators of Persona 3, 4, and 5. And tonight,
okay,
they're giving us a glimpse into the story, characters, and gameplay. Let's do this.
Okay, interesting. Another Persona.
It's a story about a world very different from ours.
'Tis a world where all people are equal and no conflict exists, much like the world His Highness once dreamt of.
To put it another way, this is a fantasy.
Video Zero.
The son of a king is dead!
Without an heir to wear the crown, what will become of the royal magic?
The fortress at the border was raised by a human mere days ago. You can only blame your
like
king's weakness.
Open world.
Who deserves his crown? A man of proven strength!
The people of my land desire a new king, and I shall provide.
Welcome one and all to the inauguration of the tournament for the throne!
Small wonder when any among the populace might be king.
Their speeches of tribal harmony mean nothing when every day they cheat and abuse us.
It tells of a world united as one tribe.
If only our lives were anything like the world in your novel.
Our lives are decided at...
It looks very Persona. Like, the style is still very Persona style.
There was a plot in his life. One I wish I'd rooted out sooner.
You're no ray of hope.
You gave up on your hopes. But I will not.
Now let's see what manner of story you'll weave.
Let's do it. You'll be a hero.
There's lots of voice acting in this trailer. Metaphor? DiFantasia? On Xbox, okay. Microsoft?
Okay, my friends, that is it for our opening act, but we are very far from done. Our big show is about to begin, but don't worry, this isn't the last you'll see of me. I'm staying all night, baby, and I cannot wait because this show is absolutely stacked. We have tons of big awards, even more world premieres of brand new games, and an incredibly special guest, a legendary actor and performer of both the stage and screen, the Muppet himself, the great Gonzo. I have to admit, I'm completely starstruck. And get this, the cast of the show based on the Fallout franchise is here to debut an exclusive new look at the series. The vault is opening in a huge way tonight. Okay, thank you all for going on this journey with me. You're the best companions a host could ask for. Let's do the boss level. The 2023 Game Awards starts now.
Welcome to the Game Awards 2023. Now, here's your host, the creator of the Game Awards, Jeff Keighley.
Okay, it's Jeff. It's the dude. She never got her warm beverage. I'm upset too. I hope Jeff can provide warm beverages for all.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the Game Awards.
He looks happier on stage than he did in the promo video. I'm just going to say that.
A global celebration of video games, and boy, do we have a show for you. I am so excited to get this started. Together, we are going to recognize outstanding creative work in games in 2023, and we'll look into the future with an astonishing lineup of world premieres. More than anything, this is a show about bringing our community together in this room and online around the world to focus on something we can all agree on. There's nothing more powerful or more immersive than an extraordinary video game. Great games comfort us, help us understand different perspectives on the
world.
Look
at his shoes. They're sneakers. They're sparkly sneakers.
That's what makes this medium different. Games, the actual things we play, are insanely special, and we're going to celebrate that for the next few hours. And we've got such an amazing group of people with us. They're built by talented creators and teams, and many of them are here tonight. Mr. Inuma, Mr. Fujibayashi, great to see you back after winning Game of the Year in 2017 for Breath of the Wild. Good luck
tonight.
Look
at them. Hi.
One of our industry's greatest creative and technical forces, Mark Cerny, PlayStation's lead system architect, celebrating 25 years of Cerny Games.
Hello.
Thank you for being here, Mark. Of course, the team behind Pizza Towers here, too. Everyone's here. Melina Jurgens, our best performance winner in 2017 for Hellblade. Welcome. I think we'll be seeing you a little bit later tonight. And we are also honored to be joined by the Tsujimoto family, Haru and Ryozo, who are celebrating 40 years of Capcom this year.
Holy
and
shit,
and the Game of the Year nomination for Resident Evil. Welcome,
guys.
So great to have you with us.
Resident Evil.
A big show, so let's get right into it. To present tonight's first award is last year's winner of Best Performance. Please join me in welcoming back to the Game Awards, yep, we're gonna do it, the actor behind Kratos in God of War, Christopher Judge.
Let's go. Let's go, Christopher Judge.
Oh, what a card. Good evening, everybody. It is such a pleasure to be back here. I have such great memories of last year, Mr. Pacino, forgetting to thank my wife.
The music.
Mother. All right. I get it. I'm not gonna stand up here making long speeches. I'm gonna stick to the script. No 8-minute speech
Let's
like
go.
Last year. But fun fact.
Infinite growth. Let's go.
My speech was actually longer than this year's Call of Duty campaign.
Oh! Oh! Oh, no. He's shooting shots. He's shooting his shots.
Another company I'll never work for. I'm here to present the award for best performance in a year of games. Beloved by audiences and acclaimed by critics, these actors delivered 6 unforgettable performances. And here are the nominees.
Best performance.
Okay, let's go.
Revenge is a weapon. It's been a long 5 years. Hope may feel beyond our grasp.
You play grown-up games, you face grown-up consequences.
Idris Elba, okay.
Did you write these pages, Mr. Wake? Wake has a double.
My name's a star.
Neil Dubon! Come on, Neil! Everyone loves... What's his face? Yuri Lowenthal is an OG actor. Yuri Lowenthal is an OG actor.
Whoever wins.
I want Neil Dubon.
Jeff has given me the okay to say, take as long as you want to. Thank everyone who's ever meant anything in your life. And I dare you. I double dare you to try to break my record 7 minutes and 9 seconds.
Call of Duty Modern Warfare?
And the award goes to...
Come on, Neil.
Neil Dubon.
Yes, Neil! Yes, Neil! made to win all of the awards. And Neil. Let's go, Neil. Yes.
Hi. This is unreal. I just wanted to say, I know I don't have much time.
He's so happy.
I'll give it a shot. Thank you so very, very much for everybody that voted. Thank my incredible fellow actors and the nominees, unbelievable talent. To be even considered amongst you is extraordinary, so thank you very much indeed. To Sven, to Larian, to all the writers, to Stephen Rooney, the writer of Astarion, I'm going to forget everybody, to Pitstop, who worked so hard, the directors, my fellow actors, 248 incredible actors that gave it heart and soul.
Baldur's Gate, let's go.
Gracias para todos. Gracias, alerta gracias, y coco también. And to my agents, I will thank you later. I'm sorry, I'm going to wrap it up, apparently. One thing I will say, please, if that's okay, the community has reached out to so many of us at Larian and said they were seen and they were represented by this game. When they lost hope, they felt isolated, they felt alone, and this game brought them together and gave them something to push through to help
love
them
that he's wearing,
and to you, I
want to
say thank you so much for seeing us. Appreciate it.
Yes!
We're not allowed to do this, none of us are. Thank you.
I'm so chuffed. I'm so glad he won. I'm so glad Neil won.
Great speech and short, so thank you. There are lots more awards to come, but now it's time to look ahead to what you'll be playing next. Let's get to those world premieres. And for the honor of presenting our first one, it's an incredible thrill to introduce a true Renaissance man. Please welcome Academy Award-winning actor and New York Times best-selling author, Matthew McConaughey.
Matthew McConaughey?
How are we doing?
This is about the celebrities from the basement.
Y'all for having me. Good to be here. What's up, everybody? Good to be here with you at the Game Awards.
The fashion choices are interesting.
I was going to come out and I was going to say the line that has preceded me on my career. All right, all right, all right. But they told me.
He's a famous actor.
No, don't do that. Come out and say.
He's in movies.
Pew.
I don't remember which ones.
Pew. All right, we'll see how that handled. I'm here tonight because I have a world premiere for you from Austin's own Archetype Entertainment. I'm also here tonight because the video game that I'm premiering is the first ever video game that I'm a part of.
Oh, let's go.
When the Archetype team first reached out to me, I was excited about becoming a part of the gaming world, but what really turned me on was when they shared the game's vision and my role in it. I will be voicing a character in this game, and all I can say is that I will have a unique relationship with every player. In this game, time moves differently. Days for you are decades for your loved ones back home.
Oh,
the choices that you make not only affect the people that you love, they'll also affect your entire civilization for generations to come. Personally, I have had some experience with time dilation. And now you can too. So now I am proud to share the first ever look at Exodus.
Okay, interesting.
Max, we need to head back.
Hold on, I'm getting a reading.
Max!
What she found that day was a miracle. It would be our salvation to fight against the Celestials, humanity's greatest enemy.
This looks cool. The character design looks really interesting.
They found us. Stop! Stay down!
The Celestials us down. I knew they'd keep chasing us until they ripped our ship apart. And I had to save her. I led them away from this world, away from her. We both knew the cost of using the gates. When you travel at light speed, time slows to a crawl. It was only days for me, but an entire lifetime passed for her. And in the chaos of those final moments, we never said goodbye. Our service, our sacrifice, discovers worlds, seeds hope, breaks empires. We are the travelers.
Okay, looks good. Is that Muse? They've got Muse. They've got like the license to Muse. Got some gameplay. It's really nice. Become the traveler. Become the traveler.
That is a very exciting project, giving me some Mass Effect vibes, and I appreciate the team sharing the first glimpse of gameplay. At the end there, looks great. All right, well now we're gonna go right on to another world premiere.
Certain you remember nothing of this place.
Oh, nothing that would help us.
Master thyself.
Tell me, brother, why exactly are we doing this?
I must face this.
Holy shit, the animation.
No shame in what just happened. It's all part of the process. Let's go again.
Okay. Gameplay. Holy shit. The gameplay. Whoa. God of War Ragnarok Valhalla. December 2023. The free DLC, it's free.
There's a very nice holiday surprise from PlayStation. Kratos and Mimir are headed to Valhalla in an adventure that blends God of War Ragnarok's combat with elements inspired by the roguelike genre for an emotional, unexpected and fun new twist. And yes, as you saw, it is free. The team at Santa Monica Studio are fans of their fans and are offering this DLC, God of War Ragnarok Valhalla, as a gift to the community, and you will be able to download it in just 5 days on December 12th. Amazing. All right, switching gears. Our next world premiere comes from a small independent team of developers in Australia. I love that this show
Australia.
Can give a platform to independent creators. Their last game in 2019 was a sensation, and their next project is equally exciting and unexpected.
Australia, let's go! I hope this is based in Australia, like the video game setting. Sounds like it. Kookaburra? That looks so Australian. Is this Blue Mountains?
Oh, there they are.
Where? Oh,
I see them.
Ah. So silly.
Let's go.
Vibe with your friends, you just vibe out, do puzzles, and hang out. I like that.
Big Wolf by House House.
2025, okay, interesting.
Super fun, right? I did a playtest of that game about a year ago and had so much fun. It is a very special and unique game, and I'm honored we got to share it with you here at the show. All right, while you're watching TGA, head to tgasteamdeck.com right now. We're doing another Steam Deck giveaway. This time it's the brand new 1 TB Steam Deck OLED featuring an HDR OLED display. Enter now only during the live show at tgasteamdeck.com for a chance to win one of 100 OLEDs. All right, trust me, we are just getting started, guys. There are so many game announcements, awards, and musical performances ahead, including the Old Gods of Asgard from Alan Wake 2. Just wait, it's amazing. We'll be right back.
I'm here to save a prince.
Are you now?
Princess Anne has been kidnapped.
Take the lead, Sargon.
You are to leave for Mount Carth at once. Bring him back. Bring back my son.
It's strange. It's a maze here, but I feel I've walked this path before.
Farum, are you all right?
I saw our kingdom engulfed in flames. There's nothing you can do to stop me.
Am I still alive?
You seem stronger, but not strong enough to save a friend yet.
Very cool, very cool. I like this.
Are you courageous enough and clever enough to save your friend?
I'll do whatever it takes.
Prince of Persia, the Lost Crown, okay. Free demo! Wow, the demo is available soon, okay. January. Lego, is this Fortnite? This is the Fortnite trailer, yeah, it's Fortnite. Lego Fortnite. Animal Logic in Australia does all the Lego movies, so I'm wondering if they did this trailer. My friend was saying this was basically Minecraft. A Lego Fortnite. Let's go Fortnite. Welcome back.
Welcome.
We're back.
A former Game Award winner for Best Performance, Ninja Theory's Melina Jurgens.
Hi. Performing an original piece from our upcoming game, Senua Saga Hellblade 2, I'm proud to introduce to you to one of my favorite bands, Heilung.
Okay, I've never heard of this band, but let's go. Oh shit, they're like a medieval band. Or like a folk band. A Viking band? They're giving Viking vibes. So cool. What the hell? Honestly, the coolest thing I've seen in a while. Holy shit. That's very cool.
I've dreamt of this. This place. Of fear and fury. Do you hear it? The heartbeat of the lost ones. I can feel them on my skin. Each death, inked in blood.
Just the environment and the character design and the combat looks really cool. It's giving me Resident Evil type combat vibes, which I like.
You want the truth? All the lives inside me.
Super
tell
realistic.
Me to let go.
Well.
The shadow will always hang over me.
Oh my god, this looks so good. Now this is how you introduce a game. Holy shit. I'm so impressed.
What will I become?
I'm so impressed by this. Senua's Saga Hellblade 2. 2024! I'm so glad that it's available on Steam. That was good. That was really good.
Alright, what an amazing new look at the gameplay and world of Hellblade 2 coming in 2024 to Xbox, PC, and Game Pass. Now to present our next award, please welcome a former Game Award winner nominated tonight for Best Fighting Game, the creative director of NetherRealm Studios, it's Ed Boon!
Oh my goodness. Hello, Ed.
The best stories are the ones we get lost in. Tonight's nominees for Best Narrative got us all in their drama and their characters, and yes, sometimes in some weird stuff we can't explain. Here are the nominees.
Best Narrative.
In a horror story, they're only victims and monsters.
Blackith blesses me this day.
Oh, this is gonna be a tight one. These games yeah, this is gonna be a fight.
He's here on some kind of hunt.
Yeah, oh god, I wonder who's gonna win. Best narrative.
And the award goes to Alan Wake 2.
Alan Wake 2! Alan Wake 2 is probably up there with my prediction. Either Alan Wake or Baldur's Gate.
Ah, thank you so much. Alan Wake 2, from the beginning, was a very story-focused project for us. I share this with the whole narrative team, the writers, Clay, Tyler, Sinikka, narrative designers who made the story into gameplay, Simone, Molly, the whole narrative team, directors working with actors, Ansi, Hannah, Rosie, Holly, all the wonderful actors here tonight, some of them, Melanie, Ilkka, Matt and David, but the whole cast, wonderful actors, and the song makers who made custom music, custom songs to extend the story here tonight later. Poets of the Fallen, Old Gods of Asgard, Poe, This Road, every songmaker coming through, fried music for our chapter songs. Thank you.
Orchestra.
We wanted to push things further, to do something new, and it's always a risk for you to embrace it and understand it. Means so much. I'll treasure this always. Thank you.
Yeah! Good job! Very cool.
アーティストとして 私たちは想像力を駆使して目に見えないものを見ることができます。私たちはボーダーレス。私たちはアーティスト。私たちはどこにでも存在する。私たちは安心。
You may have recognized that incredible creator who built her own independent studio in Tokyo, and she wanted to show you what she's been working on before she's even signed it with a publisher or a platform.
Ooh.
I said, come to this show, just show it to the audience and the fans first. So that's what we're gonna do. We're honored to have her back at the Game Awards. Please give a warm welcome to Akumi Nakamura.
Akumi!
Akumi!
Mindy, amazing gamer! Hi, Akumi Nakamura desu. Konnichiwa. I'm super excited to be on this stage again. Thank you. First, I want to say thank you to the Anshin artist, Miteru! And you, thank you, you, all you. Your support changed my life. Today, I am honored to introduce our first project, Kemuri. It's time to see the unseen. Meet it! Bye-bye!
Holy shit, look at that. Whoa! Holy shit! Whoa! That looks like a AAA studio produced that.
So many
Holy
incredible
shit.
Projects tonight. Thank you, Akumi. Now, tonight, it's not lost on me that all of our Game of the Year nominees are from big established franchises. And while we all love a big sequel, it's important to use a place like TGA to introduce you to brand new worlds like what you just saw with Kemuri. And like this project.
My sister Faye, she sings like morning. My sister True, she laughs like noon. My sister Grace, she drowned this evening. But still visits by the light of the moon. We prayed for summer, we prayed for fall. To prosper, to
this
love,
looks amazing.
To forgive. And our prayers came back like a little lost lamb, dying so that we. Not quite the same.
No rest for the wicked. That's very cool.
That's No Rest for the Wicked, an action RPG from Moon Studios, and more information is coming March 1st, as you saw with the Wicked Inside Showcase. Tonight during the Game Awards, viewers in the U.S. can enter to win one of 100 Lenovo Legion Go gaming handhelds, a Windows 11 gaming PC in your hand. Head to TGALegion.com before the end of the show to enter for your chance to win. Here's a look at the Legion Go in action.
Interesting. I have the Steam Deck, so this is going to be an interesting competitor. It's basically a Switch. A Switch Steam Deck.
The best discoveries are the ones you really feel. The thrill of exploring new worlds. The rush of victory. But there's still so much more to discover. Every choice you make is a chance to feel something new. Good luck. Have fun.
I'm gonna be right back real quick. I'm gonna grab some food whilst this runs and I'll be back. I'll leave this running.
Tears of Pandora, available now.
Hada, hada, hada. This hits.
Good day, Sot. You're just a wiffle waffle. You can't even aim when you go into battle.
I am a baron. Sure. You are a border. I write decrees. You mix mortar.
Fie on thee. I got an acre. You eat horse bread because your mom's a baker.
We have been saying it all night, but it really has been an outstanding year for gaming. And now to talk about some of the biggest games, it's a pleasure to welcome from the Muppets, that's right, the great Gonzo.
Oh, thank you, thank you. Hey, Jeff, it's great to be here. Hello, everybody.
Hey, buddy, thanks for coming. Looks like you're kind of wearing what I'm wearing.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, it's like looking in a mirror.
Oh, my God, it's the guy. It's a Muppet.
Well, I really don't think.
So, Gonzo, what have you been playing?
Seriously, what have you been playing?
Hey, everybody.
Gonzo's buying everyone popcorn tonight.
Hey, wait a minute. All right, that was a good one. You got me. Well played, Jeff.
Yeah, well, thank you. Seriously, though, what have you been playing, Gonzo?
Well, lots and lots of Tears of the Kingdom.
Tell
what
us.
An incredible game. You know that one mission where you follow the cuckoo up a hill? I lost track of how many days I spent doing that. The objective is really, you know, just follow the chicken. You don't have to ask me twice.
That's right, you do love your chicken. So I guess that was your favorite part. What did you think of the ending?
Oh, I never get past that cuckoo mission. I keep restarting to see if I can get a slower time.
All right, well, any other great gaming highlights this year for you, Gonzo?
You kidding? Actually, if you have the time, hey, you guys got a minute? I'd like to show you how many of this year's greatest games all revolve around one central theme. Check this out.
Got the case board? Yeah, that's quite a conspiracy you've uncovered.
I know. You probably think I'm obsessed with chickens, and I can't appreciate video games beyond this one very specific interest.
I mean, yeah, I think we're all thinking that.
Yeah, maybe. What do you think, Zelda? Yes! Let's do this IRL!
Chicken!
Unbelievable. All right, here are the nominees for Best Debut Indie Game.
Best Debut Indie Game.
Okay, we've got Cocoon, Dredge. What else do we have? Pizza Tower! Venba. Viewfinder.
I feel as free as a cuckoo. Yeah!
All right, the great Gonzo. Thank you, Gonzo. And now to the task at hand. The game award goes to Cocoon.
I've never heard of it.
Thank you so much. The team from Geometric couldn't make it out tonight, but they wanted us to pass along their thanks for everyone who played and voted for Cocoon. And to Yepi, Mads, and Jakob, and everyone at the team at Geometric, thank you so much for being such a wonderful partner on this game. Thank you.
The Geometric team also wanted to thank they were honored to be nominated with all the awesome studios in this category. We can't wait to see what you guys do next. Thank you.
Later tonight, we'll announce the best mobile game of 2023, but which title are you most excited to see go mobile in 2024? Google Play will be awarding the most anticipated title with their Play More Award on Twitch. So head on over to Twitch to lock your vote. And now it's time for our next world premiere.
Yo, yo.
This looks interesting. What's this about? I don't know if this is a game or a console. Like a console.
Did you save the game?
Really? Of course I did.
Let me reintroduce you. I know this game. No, I don't know this game. They had that skateboarding game in it. I was like, what is that? New energy. Jet Set Radio is a really good game. This was a Sega ad. Ah, I see.
Oh, yeah. Now, typically a world premiere reveals one game, but leave it to Sega to announce five new games in one trailer. So many memories for all of us. All of those are first of the many brand new games in development and set for release over the next several years. Thanks to Sega for that truly incredible announcement. All right, well, this next trailer might be something Dragon Ball fans have been waiting to hear about for a while. Here we go.
Is this a Dragon Ball game? Okay. Bandai Namco, you better deliver. This looks so good already. What if I take the wow. Oh.
before my power. I'll show you the horrors of hell. Now perish along with this planet!
I'm not sure about this. I'm not sure about this. I'm having questions. I'm having questions about this. I'm like, I'm having questions. Hey, Supermassive Dave.
Whatever's down there is too dangerous.
Dead by Daylight, interesting. Another survival horror game. This is taking more of a somber. Souls tied in a twine by pride and guilt.
There's darkness in the distance from the way that I've been living. But I know I can't resist it.
Very interesting. Okay. The casting of Frank Stone. So this is a interesting.
Two huge names in the horror genre, Dead by Daylight and Supermassive Games, are coming together for a brand new single-player experience, the casting of Frank Stone. Now, tonight we're showing you lots of new worlds, but now it's time to return to a world we haven't seen in quite some time.
Okay. What is that? The pigs. Wow, this is nice. Square Enix, okay. It was giving me Zelda vibes, but I'm not sure what game this is. Visions of Mana.
It is said that time marches to the beat of a drum. A fleeting moment can feel like a lifetime for those caught in its deadly rhythm. And a lifetime can pass in the blink of an eye for anyone embracing its bitter end. The only thing we know for sure is that time marches forward.
Even if we are apart, still we are one.
Without hesitation, without remorse.
Oh shit, this looks good.
If the drum drives
got a gun?
Then the
Let's do this together.
Interesting with the gun.
How many mountains must you move to alter the river below?
Let us not forget the pain of Master Shoin and the countless others who have suffered.
The gameplay looks really good. Like the game, like the movement.
As the smoke rises, so shall we.
This is Ronin. Rise of the Ronin.
Lumois, of Eldritch will sacrifice their partner for duty. So which of you will do the deed?
So many good games being released in 2024.
That's Rise of the Ronin coming to PlayStation in 2024. Now it is time to announce winners in a number of other categories. Here are the nominees for Best Action Game. Armored Core 6, Fires of Rubicon.
Dead Island 2, Remnant 2.
Ghost Runner 2, Hi-Fi Rush.
I think Armored Core.
And the Game Award goes to Armored Core
6,
Fires of Rubicon. Congratulations from... Here are the nominees for Best Art Direction. Alan Wake 2, Hi-Fi Rush,
I'm thinking Lies of P.
Super Mario Brothers Wonder, and The Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom. And the Game Award goes to Alan Wake 2.
Alan Wake.
Congrats, Remedy. Here are the nominees for Best VR AR. Gran Turismo 7, Humanity.
Resident Evil. It has to be Resident Evil.
Village VR Mode and Synapse. And the Game Award goes to Resident Evil Village VR Mode. Congratulations to Capcom. Now your nominees for Best Mobile Game. Final Fantasy.
I don't know. Hello Kitty, come on.
Hello Kitty Island Adventure.
Hello Kitty.
And Terra Nil. And the Game Award goes to
Honkai Star Rail. It's Honkai Star Rail.
Congratulations, HoYoverse.
Oh, yeah.
Much more game awards to come, including the first ever performance by the old gods of Asgard from Alan Wake 2. And some of our biggest game announcements are still to come. But right now, we'd like you to meet one of tonight's nominees for Best Debut Indie Game, who is also part of the newly inducted Future Class presented by Old Spice.
Old Spice.
My name is Abhi. In India, when I grew up, I had a very early interest in games. When I got to Canada at the age of 12, it was a whole new world for me.
Canada.
For many South Asian families, food is not just a thing to cook, but also a way of expressing affection and all the things that they cannot say. Bimba is a narrative cooking game that tells the story of an Indian mother who moves to Canada in the late 1980s. It's a story about love, loss, and family. The more local you are, the more international you become. Everybody who's played the game is able to put something from their lives into
art
it
in
ways that
gorgeous.
I wouldn't have expected.
And the story is like very interesting too. All right, we got AMD and Steam Deck. I've got a Steam Deck. It feels really nice to play on a Steam Deck. Games that are like remote control games that are natively built for like remotes and not like keyboards. The battery life is questionable.
We want you. Are you meant for better things?
I can save someone with this.
What is this? What's with the screaming? What is this? Ew!
Wait, do we have to grind the children?
What up, man? Welcome in.
Okay, now we sit down, very comfy.
Oh my goodness, what the fuck is this?
Give you purpose. Sometimes the finger of God reaches down and touches you.
Ew! Yucky!
Stop by one of
This looks fun, but the amount of gore in this. This is another Bioshock? The Outlast Trials, okay? That's something I'm gonna play. Babe, beast.
Nicotine addiction can make stress worse.
Oh, this is an ad. The vape beast.
Okay,
stay away from
to the
it.
Game Awards, and are you ready? It is time to get a world premiere from one of our industry's greatest creators. He's been a huge supporter of the Game Awards since the very beginning back in 2014, and tonight I am so honored to share this latest update with you on his upcoming project. Here we go.
Hideo Kojima. It's a Silent Hill.
The hungry purple dinosaur ate the kind zingy fox, the jabbering crab, and the mad whale, and started bending and quacking.
Oh my god, hello Penta!
The kind zingy fox.
That's interesting!
The jabbering crab and the mad whale and started bending and cracking.
This looks Hunter Schafer, okay?
The hungry purple dinosaurs ate the kind zingy fox.
The ad is.
The jabbering crab and the mad whale. And started wending and quacking.
You don't care? This is a very interesting. Oh! Wow. Okay. Interesting. Interesting. It's using meta humans, so it's using AI. Interesting. Oh my goodness.
Please welcome the visionary game developer behind OD, Mr. Hideo Kojima!
They gave him a door! I can't believe that! They gave him a door! A special door! On the stage!
Welcome, Mr. Kojima, back to the Game Awards.
Thank you, Jeff.10回目となる記念すべきこの TGA で、新作のゲーム OD、発表できて非常に嬉しいです、このゲームには、ソフィア、リリスと、ハンター・シェーファーとウドキアさんが出演されます、はい、
I'm really glad to be at the 10th Game Awards. Really happy to show the new title OD, and this title will featureMain role Sophia Lillis, Hunter Schafer, and Udo Kier.
I think we all want to know more, of course. What kind of game are you making, Mr. Kojima?
尖ったゲームっていうのを今作ってます。で、今までないものなんで、言葉で説明はしにくいんですけども、これもちろんゲームです。遊んで楽しめるゲームなんですけども、ある種映画でもあって、さらに、新しいメディアになるかもしれないという可能性を秘めたものです。
So I really like to always challenge new things, groundbreaking things, and that's my kind of rule. But this one,with help of Xbox Game Studios and using their cloud gaming technology, I'm kind of doing this together. But it's really to make immersive and also something that no one has seen before is what I'm trying to do. And it is a game, don't get me wrong, but it's at the same time a movie, but at the same time a new form of media.
It's gonna be like an interactive film.
Can't wait to learn more about what you're working on. Wait. Is there somebody else at the door?
What's at the door? These cameos.
Everyone, please welcome Jordan Peele to the Kojimaverse.
Jordan Peele? They're just getting the celebrities out, left, right, and center. Jordan Peele? Let's go, Jordan. This is going to be interesting.
How's it going?
Jordan Peele's
Jordan,
horror films.
To the Game Awards. What a fun surprise. I know,
like,
you're
his portfolio of
games, right?
A huge fan of Hideo.
Like,
this
his body
icon
of work
and,
is interesting.
I can say from the first moment I played Metal Gear Solid 2, I knew I was experiencing the work of an artist whose craft just hits different. And he's been an inspiration to me, and the opportunity to collaborate with him is truly incredible. In my films, I'm always trying to maximize the immersion, put the audience into
the main character's
shoes.
This is an interesting collaboration. I am excited to see.
Hideo is the master of this, and he does it on a whole nubba level. And what he's cooking up here is completely immersive, utterly terrifying, and I am absolutely honored to be collaborating with the GOAT. Let's go!
Let's go!
Two GOATs working together. Hideo, I want to ask you, how are you collaborating with Jordan? Tell us about it.
Jordan is a genius to be called by the few creators of the world. And I was a huge fan of his. でお会いして非常に気が合うので、もう最初に会った時から、昔からの知り合いみたいな幼なじみみたいな感じで、で僕は映画を見て育ってゲームを作っています。でジョーダンは、ゲームを、遊びながら育って映画を作ってるんで、この2人が一緒にコラボするの非常に面白いかなというので、ジョーダンと一緒にものを作り出しました。
Well, Jordan is one of those genius, and I've been a big fan of him. And when I met him, I felt like we were friends from the past. We get on very well. We like things that we both
good.
Like, and we're really happy, and we wanted to collaborate
very
something.
Very good at
and
translating,
this
like,
time,
the tone.
Well, Jordan, I grew up watching movies, and I'm a game creator now. Jordan grew up playing games, and he's a movie director now. So this two collaboration will be really awesome. So that's why I wanted to do something together with Jordan.
あとですね、
Yes.
I love the guy in the suit of armor. Just fully wearing a suit of armor.
多くの、クリエイティブサポーターとか、人たちと、参加が予定されてます。で、それぞれの恐怖っていうのの焦点を当ててもらってストーリーテリングしてもらうと予定です。で、ここではそのメンバーを紹介できませんけども、非常に豪華な布陣というか巨匠たちの集まりなんで、僕はその彼らを集めてアベンジャーズと呼んでます。ぜひ楽しみにしてください。
So, what I could say right now is that I'm kind of it's not just Jordan. I have other creative collaborative partners with me on board on this project. I can't really say who they are right now, but they are the legends, and they're going to be amazing. And I actually call them the Avengers.
Elden Ring to write the world building
stuff. Doors closed for now, so no more special guests, but it's going to be amazing.
It's a very similar
collaboration. I just want to stress that what this man is building here is unlike any other game. It is going to be crazy. That's it.
We cannot wait to learn more. Hideo Kojima, Jordan Peele, thank you so much, guys.
Very cool. Very cool.
All right, it's time for another game announcement. This one's 65 million years in the making.
I own an island off the coast of Costa Rica. Really spectacular, spared no expense. For this place, I wanted to show them something that wasn't an illusion.
Jurassic Park? Are you kidding me? Oh.
Can anyone hear me? This is Dr. Maya Joshi. I've been left behind on Isla Nublar.
Dinosaur survival game. But they've made it more. I was expecting. Wait. Not sure about the like where this is set. Like it's set in the 80s or 90s.
Is anyone there?
Dinosaur. That is some very good framing. I wonder if there are any other cast members. Jurassic Park Survival, okay. Love a good horror survival game. Dinosaur survival game, I'm all for it.
Please welcome Grammy Award-winning producer, Zed.
Zed?
Hello, everybody. I'm honored to be here tonight to present the award for Best Audio Design. Sound is an often overlooked but crucial aspect of game development. It's what brings games to life, creating the immersive worlds we love to explore.
He's got two
watches on. It's the eerie noises deep in a forest.
I'm sorry.
The echoes inside an abandoned spacecraft, or the satisfying sound of shooting a web. This year, we've seen some incredible examples of audio design in games as talented sound designers have pushed the boundaries of what's possible. Here are the nominees.
Interesting. Let's go.
Best audio design.
Alan Wake is probably going to get this award. Dead Space, interesting. Maybe Hi-Fi Rush. Just because the music in Hi-Fi Rush is good. Resident Evil 4 is also a good contender.
And the game award goes to Hi-Fi Rush.
Hi-Fi Rush! I thought so. Because Hi-Fi Rush is a... Ooh! I can't see the link! No!
Thank you so much. このような素晴らしい賞をいただきありがとうございます。制作チーム一丸となって取り組んだ成果を評価していただけたことを大変嬉しく思います。制作をサポートしてくださった皆様、また作品を応援していただいた皆様に心より感謝いたします。本当にありがとうございます。
Just a quick translation. Thank you for this amazing award. It's so glad that the work that the team has done together to achieve has been recognized here. Thank you to everyone who supported this project. And for myself, thank you to our family, friends, partners, pets. Thank you everyone at Bethesda, ZeniMax, Microsoft, and all the players out there for going with this ridiculous project. Most of all, to the team at Tango for taking such a wild idea and making it a reality. Thank you so much.
All right, let's turn to the world of Fortnite. If you haven't already, check out the Game
Awards
Island in Fortnite. It's been updated with new trophies tonight to collect. Fortnite is expanding into a full-on platform with tons of new experiences beyond Battle Royale. Earlier today, LEGO Fortnite launched, and on Saturday, the music game Fortnite Festival. Tomorrow, though, the team at Psyonix behind Rocket League delivers Rocket Racing. Here's your first look.
Rocket Racing, let's take a look at Epic. It took me a while to start to like actually enjoy and like Fortnite. I was a bit overwhelmed by the sheer amount of just like the cosmetics in this game, and the amount of things that you can do, and like the amount of like, the craziness of Fortnite. Now you can drive a car and race it. Actual gameplay and in-game cinematics. Hold sway. This is interesting.
Their glory fades through time in tombs of somber gray. You too want to be an immortal?
Master, are there more good folks in the world or bad?
More good, of course.
Then why is there always suffering? And why do the bad folks always win?
Because goodness without teeth punishes not. It only foments evil. Cleanse the world with blood and grow lotuses in it. That is your destiny.
This is gorgeous. Hello, Diluc.
I, the keeper of the New West, welcome the destined one.
The destined one who doesn't even know what he's destined for? Those old rascals, they surely know how to name.
Tell me, is my kind destined for extermination?
You're driven by glory, not destiny.
So this is the face of the destined one. It will fit me just as well.
Wow. Yet preaching peace. This is gorgeous.
Enlightened me. What justifies your superiority?
Welcome to the Game Awards. What the hell? What is this? Black Myth Wukong. So many good game releases coming in 2024.
Batman, Green Lantern, The Flash, Superman.
I don't care. I don't really care that much about Marvel or DC games. I just don't care for them.
Justice League will burn this earth down for me.
Like, I hope the game franchise is more.
You have to kill us,
Diana.
Enjoyable,
we
have to
but
die
I don't
to
care.
Save the world. We can work with that.
They got gorillas.
You think you're a team now?
You think you can stop us?
Thought you'd never ask.
Pick and choose, sit and lose, all you different crews. Chicks and dudes, who you think is really
true? It's got FPS, we're jumping around.
He's the fastest man alive, according to all these girlfriends.
We got a random Australian and or British person.
The plan.
Time for us bad guys to save the world.
Is this Justice? Another Justice League game?
Come on.
It's Suicide Squad. Okay, interesting.
Suicide Squad. Interesting. Joining me now are Rebecca and Megan from Digital Extremes up in Canada to talk about all things Warframe. We've got a special Warframe Twitch drop tonight for those of you watching on Twitch. But I understand you've also got some other news for Warframe fans on the next expansion, right?
Yeah, we do. You know, it's been 10 years for Warframe, so, you know, 10 years for you. We assumed we'd get a senior's discount of some time, just because our game is probably the oldest game here, maybe. But, yeah, we
keep
have...
going strong.
Oh, good old
Warframe. I know,
it's because
our community is so awesome, and we are going to be showing you the release date for our next major update for Warframe. So we do have a trailer for, you know, Warframe players around the world to watch, which is quite exciting.
Yeah, I mean, it's been an incredible ride, 10 years of just our incredible developers, our community, just supporting us along the way. So if you're a Warframe fan and watching, we love you and thank you so much. And I hope you enjoy the next update, Whispers in the Walls.
Oh yeah, thanks for having us back too. Devs at home, we love you guys.
All right, thanks guys. Let's take a look.
For generations, you've slept. No purpose, no call to wake you. But now, you have changed everything.
The lidless eye has seen you, the Tano.
Interesting.
Don't be late.
Hello. Interesting Warframe. Whispers of the Walls. Is that a DLC? Interesting.
There is so much more Game Awards ahead. You thought the surprises were done? Nope, there's lots coming, but while you're here, head to supergameawards.com through December 31st for a chance to win a trip for four to the brand new Super Nintendo World.
It's a really
Universal
old
Studios,
game.
Hollywood.
It's,
here's a look.
It's one of the older games. It's really good. It's a free, it's mostly free to play.
Ready for a new way to play? Experience the immersive world of Super Mario. Brought to life like never before.
You know, Honkai Star Rail already won an award. I'm waiting for Genshin Impact to be mentioned.
Universal Studios Hollywood.
I'm waiting for Genshin to be mentioned. So far, my predictions have been on and off. Oh, thank you, Carrie. Thank you. It's her masterpiece. Esquire. Yeah, the Mobile Awards, I'm waiting. So far, I think we've got almost 1 hour left. The Game Awards runs for 3 hours, I think. But exciting. There's been some exciting games that have been released.
Life to the living.
Death.
Let's go, Narvia.
To the dead. We have sworn to protect the living from the lingering dead.
Keep the incarnate and the invisible separate.
To bring peace on errant souls.
Once their grip on this world is broken.
4.3 live stream, let's go!
Life to the living.
Death to the dead.
Life to the living. Death to the dead.
Life to the living. Death to the dead. Honoring my oath. Or sacrificing the living to bring me back. I'm not sure I can do that.
Honor your oath or bring me back. But don't leave me like this.
This is interesting. Ghost? Wow, action figures.
This call is being recorded. What is your emergency?
I need the police. You can get the police right away.
I'm sorry.
Help.
You ready?
Suspect down! Right is down!
We got you.
Cover!
We gotta get you up.
Look out!
Ready?
Drop
it! Officer is down and we need backup.
Let's go! Get back!
You can still make it out of this. Drop the gun and let her go.
I'm not going in!
Is this Call of Duty? What is this? This has plot. What's
so,
the plot?
Are you ready?
Ready or not? It's interesting. Okay. It's a new game.
Age of Empires, Call of Duty Warzone Mobile, Little Nightmares, and Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six are just some of the big titles coming to mobile in 2024.
Okay, mobile games.
Head to the Game Awards on Twitch to vote for which title you want to win Google Play's own Play More Award. Now, please welcome last year's winner of Games for Impact for the game As Dusk Falls, which is coming to PlayStation on March 7th and is available for pre-order tonight. Creative Director Caroline Marshall.
Bonsoir, everyone. Winning last year was definitely a highlight of my 22 years in the industry. Games for Impact is one of the most important categories at the Game Awards. The games nominated this year offer unique and nuanced perspectives on topics that concern us all, from the climate crisis to cultural diversity. They broaden our horizons, foster empathy, and connect us as humans. In a world torn apart by divisions and intolerance, this is one of the most essential powers of our medium. Here are the outstanding nominees.
Let's see what we have. Games for Impact. Ooh, this looks good.
A traveler will reunite the people.
Chance of Sinar.
Using this year to make an impact.
Goodbye, Volcano High. Chia. Terra Nil. I want Venba to win.
And the Game Award goes to. Chia!
Chia, okay. Never heard of it. If you ever want a new game to play, this is the stream. There's so many games.
Thank you. I accept this award on behalf of developer ourselves, who cannot be here, but I got a message from Phil Clifford,
Shuhei
co-founder
Yoshida.
Of ourselves. I'd like to thank Ourself family for your trust and unbelievable talent. Kepler and Sony
Let's
for believing
Genshin.
In this crazy project. And the entire population of New Caledonia who championed and embraced cheer all along. Thank you, merci, Oleti.
Yeah, cheer.
Hello. I'm Abubakar Salim. I'm mainly known for my acting work in Raised by Wolves and Assassin's Creed Origins.
Let's go.
But that is not why I'm here. Oh, okay. Sorry, now this is crazy, man. I mean, I remember watching the Game Awards when I was younger, so being up here now is like, Look, I've loved games all my life. I played them all my life, man, from Kingdom Hearts, Garry's Mod. Golden Sun. And it started
Gary.
With my dad, right? He got me into them. He understood, you know, that games are an art form. You know, it's a great space to enjoy and escape from the reality of the world. And he passed away a while back, and I'll tell you what, I'm still figuring it out. But 4 years ago, I decided that I needed to try and process my grief in a way that felt true to me and him. So I took the biggest risks of my life and threw everything that I had in making a game, a piece of art that honored him, an ode to the people we have loved and lost. So the reason I'm here tonight is because with the love and support of a lot of people here, I'm gonna take another big risk and I'm gonna show you what we've been building. No, I'm gonna offer you this game, a game from my old man. I hope you like it.
Every story begins at the end of another. Each story carries with it the echoes of those that came before.
Ridley Scott, a creative role. Wow.
My father.
Critical role.
Your story was snatched away too soon. My name is Zhao, a shaman of Kenzera. Here, I seek my father's return.
This looks sick. What the fuck? It's like a very cool platformer. Like, I'm not really interested in platformer games, but like some of these games are piquing my interest.
I will not stop.
Yeah.
Kalunga, God of Death, hear my plea. Kalunga, God of Death, come to me. Show me you are ready.
Tales of Kenzera Zhao. Very cool. You can pre-order after the show. Holy shit. Life is strange. Okay, so this is set in 1995. It's like a horror film? Like a horror game? Or survival? Or like, there's fantasy element to this.
It's been 27 years, y'all. Why now?
Because we made a promise.
Ooh, it's giving me Stranger Things vibes.
That was Lost Records, a brand new world from the development team behind Life is Strange. Now we have a world premiere, a new look at a game based on an ongoing franchise of 18 years with over 850 million users worldwide. This entirely in-engine trailer shows off the blend between cartoon 3D graphics with hardcore action. This is the first Berserker.
The first Berserker?
Finally, I found you. Trampled by the one you trusted. Abandoned from your king. You thought you were a hero.
Whoa, okay.
Now, you are just one of us.
Whoa. The art style. It's as if Elden Ring and like Genshin Impact was like a merged together.
This is no ordinary ghost. You'll have to risk your life.
Giving me like Kingdom Hearts. Yeah, anime God of War, yeah. Like the shaders are really in, like the combination of the shaders, the 3D shaders are interesting. The first Berserker Kazan, interesting. That looks good.
Looks good, right? All right, now it's time for our first performance by the Game Awards Orchestra.
Let's get it.
This is a little bit of a twist. They're about to play music from an upcoming game that no one has heard yet. You might call it one of those world premieres, and this is a special one. It's written by one of the greatest video game composers of all time, the legendary Nobuo Uematsu. Here is the Game Awards Orchestra, led by Lauren Balfe, with lead vocals from Lauren Allred, debuting the theme song from Final Fantasy VII.
Ooh!
Enjoy!
Let's go! Final Fantasy Rebirth. This is some old school anime music for sure. This is anime power ballad. This is, you sing this at karaoke. Holy shit! She wins the award for best dressed, best outfit of this whole entire award show. Also, she has a beautiful voice, obviously, but like her outfit is amazing. You show up to an award show. D-Loof. D-Loof, this is a bot. Today, D-Loop, not today. Let me enjoy my games awards and the fashion and the beauty and the artistry. Not today.
What an absolutely beautiful song from Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, which is nominated for Most Anticipated Game tonight. Thank you to Lauren Allred and Maestro Lauren Balf and the Game Awards Orchestra. They will be back later to pay tribute to our Game of the Year nominees.
Yeah!
But that's not all we have tonight.
That's not all.
Final Fantasy fans.
Any Final Fantasy fans in here? What I've never done. Played it.
That's set in stone. Or so they'll
ever.
Tell you,
I haven't played any of
because
it.
Because the future has the power to change anything. Even the past. Strap in, Newty.
Yeah, I've never played any
of
it.
To get mighty interesting.
I know someone that's like a long-term player of it. Apex Legends and Final Fantasy? What is this collaboration? That's interesting. That's more of like a
That's a very fun one. Limits are made to be broken when Final Fantasy VII Rebirth comes to Apex Legends on January 9th.
How?
That key art you just saw was drawn by Nomura-san himself. Thank you so much for that incredible announcement.
Yeah,
now
interesting.
Now it's time to announce the winners of a few more awards as selected by the fans and our voting jury. In the category of Best Score and Music, the nominees are Alan Wake 2, Baldur's Gate 3,
I think it's Hi-Fi Rush.
Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. And the Game Award goes to Final Fantasy.
Let's go.
Congratulations. Here are the nominees for Best Independent Game.
All right. Cocoon, what do we think?
Dave the Diver, Dredge,
Dave
sea of
the
Stars,
Diver,
and Viewfinder. And the Game Award goes to Sea of Stars. Congrats, Sabotage. Here are the nominees for Best Community Support. Baldur's Gate 3, Cyberpunk 2077,
Ooh, I don't know.
Destiny 2,
I really
Final
don't know
Fantasy
about
14,
this.
And No Man's Sky. And the Game Award goes to Baldur's Gate 3.
Baldur's Gate.
Congratulations, Larian. All right. Nominees for Best Fighting Game. Those are God of Rock, Mortal Kombat 1. Nickelodeon,
I'm not sure.
All-Star
Mortal Kombat
2,
1.
Pocket Bravery and Street
or
Fighter
Street
6.
Fighter 6.
And the Game Award this year goes to Street Fighter 6.
Yeah, I thought either one of those two.
All right. Most anticipated game. Your nominees this year were Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, Hades 2.
I think Hades 2, you know.
Star Wars Outlaws and Tekken 8. And the Game Award this year goes to Final Fantasy VII Rebirth.
Final Fantasy. The Final Fantasy fandom is winning today.
Right.
The nation
well,
is winning.
It's been 8 months since the release of Honkai Star Rail, a winner tonight for Best Mobile Game. This space fantasy RPG filled with myths and legends is set for more intergalactic expeditions
Let's
in 2024. And tonight, we have an exclusive look at Penacane, the next destination.
Voyeurverse?
Do you still remember it? Fable. About the stars. Its stories tell of what is and what was. Its pages will always reveal something new.
I think Voyeurverse has better just art direction in general.
Unforgettable memories, but they are only a beginning.
Is that Argenti? Yes, it is.
It won't all be merrymaking.
D-Luc if he wasn't traumatized. That's Argenti.
Added to the final draft of the story.
I really wish I enjoyed the gameplay of Honkai Star Rail, but I can't get into it.
The path of the Trailblaze will continue.
It's a beautiful game, gorgeous.
One of these pages, I'll appear in your story too.
Welcome to Penacone, young lady. May I ask your name?
Acheron, the Galaxy Ranger.
Ooh, cool.
A nominee tonight for best mobile game, Monster Hunter Now is the new mobile game from Niantic and Capcom. Like all Niantic's games, Monster Hunter Now is played in the real world, and tonight they have a special in-game event going on right now with new monsters, new weapons, and special free game items for new players to join the hunt. It's available now for iPhone and Android, so check it out, Monster Hunter Now. Coming up, we've got an exclusive new look at the new Fallout series. We'll be right back.
You don't like Fortnite? Fortnite is very, it's growing on me. Fortnite is growing. I didn't like it at first because it was just too overwhelming. Three-player co-op pirate ship adventure, let's go. Let's yell at each other in VoIP. Master Naval Warfare. This is something that I haven't done before in a game. Like, Naval Warfare. You hate it? That's fair. Fortnite is very hit or miss. Like, I can't play Fortnite alone. Like, I have to play it in co-op. Skull and Bones.
All right, we're back here at the Game Awards, and that was a new look at Skull and Bones from Ubisoft, which is coming out on February 16th. I'm happy to announce that players can register now for the upcoming closed beta from December 15th to 18th on all platforms. And now it's time for the announcement of the next game from the studio that won Best Game Direction
in
2021.
Bethesda.
Votre attention. Le soleil est sur le point de se coucher. Tous les citoyens sont priés de se mettre à l'abri en intérieur jusqu'à l'aube. Attention. The sun is currently setting. All citizens are required to shelter indoors.
Turn that shit up.
I really like the new sort of modern art style where it's like,
relax,
it's realistic,
man.
But it's like
fight.
Stylized. Like this type of art style, I really enjoy. It's not like creepy or uncanny valley, like they've got
like
some like, stylized rendering.
Night's just getting started.
Blade! Blade! Okay. I didn't know that Blade was Marvel. I only care about Blade.
Joining me now are Dinga Bacaba from Arcane Leon and Bill Roseman from Marvel
Blade,
to tell us how did this come together, guys?
Well, Jeff, let me tell you, the secret superpower of Marvel Games is our constant focus on bringing together world-class talent with the fan-favorite characters that they love. Now, we are huge fans of Arcane Leon, not only because of the story-rich games they create with innovative gameplay, but
okay,
because of their
coat
authentic
is very
passion.
Cool. I like his coat.
And that's why,
it's a sick
on
coat.
Blade's 50th anniversary, we are so honored to announce this true Marvel team-up.
Yes, and after Dishonored and Deathloop, our first order of business was to make another very arcane game, but with a title that is easier to say in a French accent. And when we had, you know, when Sébastien Mitton and I had an opportunity to chat with Marvel, said, okay, let's really challenge them. Let's present our wildest take on a superhero that we both love.
And we ate it up.
They
I mean, the arcane touch fits
he
Blade.
He cooked and they
like
ate. Let's go.
Trench coat. And I mean, think about it. It's a mature action adventure game, single player, where you get to play Blade your way. For true believers, it's a dream come true.
Very excited to learn more. Dinga, why this character?
Well, he's the Daywalker. Eric Brooks is half man, half vampire, torn between the warm society of the living and the rushing power of the undead.
I love vampire stories.
As a kid of mixed origins, his dual heritage resonated with me. So yes, it is a dream
Blade
to be making
Star
a game
Real?
About Blade in Paris, my hometown.
No, it's, you know, Paris Blade.
Well, if... if my hometown was walled in, and we shared it with bloodthirsty invaders that come out as soon as the sun goes down, ça serait un petit peu la merde, quand même.
Anything else you can tell us about the game? I know it's pretty early, right?
I can tell you one thing.
Okay.
The entire team at Arcane Lyon is, you know, pouring so much love into this immersive third-person action-adventure set in the heart of Paris. Yeah. So please sit back, let us cook, and
yes.
Ah, merci beaucoup. Merci.
Wow. Oh my God, he kicked the air.
Stunts too. Dinga Bell, thank you very much, guys.
He, he kicked
right.
us.
Thanks,
Dinga. Let's
go. Right. Now please welcome the star of Twisted Metal, a nominee tonight for Best Adaptation, Anthony Mackie.
Anthony Mackie. I don't know who that is. Is he famous? I think
thank
he is. I'm not sure.
Thank you. Everybody gave up. You guys didn't. Hey, I just want to say a big thank you to everyone who watched Twisted Metal on Peacock. And I have one thing to do before I get on to the award I'm supposed to represent up here. Okay? Okay, all right. I know I say a lot of different things. You can't scream them all. Now, no one knows this yet, so you three guys and everybody else is going to be the first. Because of our incredible fans, Twisted Metal is coming back for season 2 on Peacock. So, everybody get your motor revving, because you're going on another ride with John Doe. You look great. You guys see this section right here? You guys look great. Keep it going, baby. I don't trust this dude, but y'all look great. Don't you yell at me. I love you more. I love you. What is wrong with y'all?
Some of these hosts are really good, and some of them are not
too.
So. Like, some of them aren't as charismatic.
Shut up.
Okay. Today. The best
that's the point,
like
dude.
Living universe is constantly expanding with new content and challenges.
Come
right?
on.
And that's what
Who
this
is
award
it?
For best ongoing game recognizes. The games that continue to deliver fresh experiences for their loyal communities.
Ooh.
Here are the nominees.
That best guy's all charisma. Game. He's all charisma.
Like
Apex.
Through.
Apex Legends, Cyberpunk.
No gun, no fun.
The hour has come, free.
Oh, this is a tight one. I don't know who's gonna win. Fortnite. I think maybe Fortnite. Genshin Impact! Come on, Genshin! Best ongoing game. Come on, Genshin. I've been playing this shit for 3 years now.
I get so many cool points with my sons.
Come on, Genshin.
All right. So, the game award goes to... Shut up. Shut up. Cyberpunk 2077.
See, Cyberpunk is like X-rated.
This is heavy, dude.
And it's like, it's got nudity in it. Like real, like it's fucking... heavy. I wasn't sure. I thought it really was going to be Fortnite or either Genshin, but...
What a journey. What a journey it's been. Holy. Video games are awesome. This is an incredible
run. Ghost didn't win, yeah.
From... launch to 1.5 to 2.0 in Phantom Liberty, and now the Ultimate Edition. Like, the tenacity
I like that Cyberpunk is
the
making a comeback because
its launch was
shit. Its launch was horrific.
Worlds that are immersive. You know, the world
so
being
I'm glad
immersive,
that they're
and of
winning
course
awards
the gameplay
now.
Just being fun. Fun as hell.
It's a good
this
win
This is exciting.
Them.
Team, we accept this on behalf of hundreds of people who put their hearts and souls in it. The two of us here. Please, Sasuke, including this guy here. Please, say something.
And I mean, I have to include here our amazing players. They've been with us throughout the whole journey. Gave us
the whole journey, yeah.
Videos, you know, wrote, posts on
the,
Twitter.
The launch.
It was amazing, you know, to see the reception
oh,
of
the launch.
When they were actually getting all
Let's
of those
Let's go,
updates.
Cyberpunk.
Just
Let's go.
Shipped update 2.1 for Cyberpunk. 2077.
It was a rough time for them.
Thank you so much.
The launch.
Thank you. Thank you.
So I'm glad that they get their awards now. Good job. Game should never have been released.
Congratulations, guys.
Like that early.
Worked on some truly memorable games over the past 20 years, like GTA 5, Bully, Need for Speed Underground, and the Red Dead Redemption series. Now he leads a new studio, Lightspeed LA. Steve C. Martin is here to unveil a brand new project. Steve?
Thanks, Jeff.
Great to have you here. You showed this to me earlier this year. Tell us a bit about it.
It's an honor to be here, so thanks for having us. Over the past few years at Lightspeed LA, myself and a remarkable team of over 200 talented, diverse industry veterans and fresh new talent have been in deep development on a fully original, AAA, futuristic open world game.
Ooh,
tonight,
open world.
We're really excited to offer you all a sneak peek at what we've been working on. I'm so excited to share so much more with you in the future. But for now, I hope you all enjoy this first taste.
Amazing, let's take a look, Steve, here we go.
This is different. Star Wars? Set in like sci-fi Japan or China? I'm trying to think with what the setting is. It looks Japanese, like futuristic, apocalyptic, sci-fi Japan. It's an open world, so that's gonna be interesting. I'm not sure about the combat.
Lift your head.
Whoa.
Now open your eyes, slowly. Take a breath and look around you.
The giant enemy looked really cool. Like, the enemy design looked really nice.
That was the first Descendant, which is launching the summer of 2024 from Nexon. Now we have a new look at HoYoverse's next big game, Zenless Zone Zero.
Woo!
Urban Fantasy ARPG. I have my eye on this one for a while. We had it at GameStop,
yes.
And we're excited to unveil their latest announcement right here at TGA.
Let's go. Let's go. Finally, right? The character designs are gorgeous. I love these designs. Wow. I wonder if this is going to be turn-based or if this is going to be like open world like Genshin. I'm not sure. I can't really tell at the moment. ZZZ! 2024! Yes! Maybe they'll make one in the future. Is that all battle made? Like, Noelle's a battle made. Is this Armored Core? I think it is. Transformers, I'm not sure. It's Mecha Break. It's none of those
games.
We brought
in gamers to demo the latest Cyberpunk update.
NVIDIA, okay.
Let's see what happens when they find out.
This looks amazing.
Ray tracing is beautiful.
Yeah, super real.
What do you think's powering your gaming?
Like a 4090?
40 series?
You're actually playing on a Chromebook Plus.
Wow.
A Chromebook?
Oh,
What the heck? Oh my god. That's cursed. I'm sorry, you can't put that in there. You can't put that in there, that's cursed. You're actually playing on a Chromebook.
The tide of war is turning against us. As we battle against
the
automaton threat grows more menacing by the day. We need valiant soldiers to take on these deadly robotic hordes and spread our message of peace and democracy. Use the galaxy's most advanced weaponry. Fight alongside a squad worth dying for. Join the Helldivers. Join the fight for freedom. Enlist today.
I like the voice actor. I like the voice actor. He really stole the idea.
Your life? My honor.
Okay,
is my
what's
life.
Next?
What is your craft? My craft is death. What is your pledge? My pledge is eternal service.
Space Marine? Okay, that's Warhammer, okay. What
okay,
is going on
now
here
now? We have a special surprise for you, live and exclusively here at the Game Awards.
Welcome, welcome, welcome. I am your host, Warlin Dor, and I present to you the All Gods of Asgard featuring that best-selling writer, Alan Wake. This is Herald of Darkness.
Woo! Look at the curtain!
From what I gathered, you grew up nice and sheltered with Mama's pretty stories and your own made-up fury.
And Mama gave me a magic clicker. Well, yes, I think it's true and fair to say.
I was not expecting any of this. Let's go! iPad and a bass and a guitar. This performance is, I don't know, I haven't played Alan Wake 2, but I'm wondering if this is actually in the game or not. I think the first live performance was my favorite. With the Viking band.
And all your stories of crime and chilling thrillers of hard-boiled killers became bestsellers. It was all too much. I had to get away.
Does this make anyone want to play Alan Wake 2? Put your hands up. Press F if you want to play Alan Wake 2. Because I don't know if I do or don't want to play Alan Wake 2 after watching this. What is going on? It's so fun. It's so fun, but at the same time, I don't know what the fuck is going on. I might play Alan Wake 2 just because of this. The dancing, though. Yeah! Alan Wake 2! Let's go! We love that! We love when you dance on the stage like that. Yeah!
Oh wow, that was the fabulous Poets of the Fall performing in the role of Old Gods of Asgard. Thank you to the band, Sam Lake, Remedy Epic, the cast, and everyone involved to bring that performance to life, something you will only see right here on the Game Awards. Now it's time for an update on a game we announced back at TGA in 2017.
Okay. Get the fuck out, the final chapter. Interesting.
We all shared the same story. The same fate. A family of strangers. A strange family. We have lived a thousand lives. We have died a thousand times. Whoever we were before this torture, we are now as one. Until the end. One final battle.
Interesting, the final chapter.
Joining me now is Ulf from 10 Chambers. Crazy, that was 6 years ago we announced GTFO, and that's the final chapter. You've got a free weekend on Steam. Looks fantastic, but I think there's a little something more you're also working on, right?
Yeah, first of all, I have to say thank you for having me again.
Of course.
And you delicious man, you. This suit is fucking amazing. Yeah.
You look good too.
Your games
look great. So.
Anyway, we're working on something new.
Yeah.
And it's like a passion project, like all our projects are.
And this you were known for Payday, things like that. So you're back to some heist stuff?
I guess.
Okay.
Yeah. So now we're back to doing a heist game again. And it's sort of a sci-fi thing that I've been dreaming up since I was a kid, basically.
Okay.
And it's, you know.
Should
it
we
is
announce
what it
to
is.
The world?
Yes, we should.
You've been working on this for a number of years.
Yes.
I'm so excited. It's finally time.
Thank you.
Check out the new game from Ulf and 10 Chambers. Here we go.
Mr. Bowman, your reservation at Manon Aphis is in
order. Cancel the reservation. Reset the procedure.
Continued neuroprodding may severely damage the suspect.
Reset the procedure.
Yes, standing by.
Inject. Your subconscious was just spilling the beans about your recent Akajima district break. Let's continue. What are you hoping to find in the Nexus Sentinels,
you mother?
There's no use in fighting. I will get what I want. So that's how you found out about our Akajima vault. What were you looking for?
A key.
A key to what?
Do you really want to know?
Yes! What's the key for?
It's not what, Mr. Bowman. It's who. You see, just like me, you're caught here. You're caught in the den of wolves.
Whoa!
Yeah.
has a lot of like Dead Space like games that are being released, like just trapped on a ship. Whoa.
That was Exoborn. I met with the team at Gamescom to take a look at that upcoming tactical open world extraction shooter. And the project
extraction
is led
shooter,
by some of the
yeah.
creators of The Division. And besides facing other players and warring factions, vertical gameplay, as you saw in The Forces of Nature, unlocked the potential of the player's exo-rigs to help master the apocalypse, as they say. Much more is coming in 2024 on Exoborn. Now, please welcome the voice of Loki in Asgard's Wrath 2, one of the most ambitious and anticipated VR games yet, Matt Mercer.
Matt Mercer, boss! The Critical Role guy, that guy, Matt Mercer, let's go.
I am so beyond excited to show you this trailer for Asgard's Wrath 2. I've been working with the Sanzaru team and bringing Loki to life. It's just been absolutely amazing. And after playing Asgard's Wrath 2 as a lifelong gamer, I'm honestly blown away. So I'm honored to be a part of this franchise and want to thank everyone at Sanzaru Games, at Oculus Studios, and MetaQuest. So without further ado, let's enjoy the trailer for Asgard's Wrath 2.
MetaQuest, okay, Facebook. Facebook.
The gods take everything from mortals.
Bleed these lands dry.
Interesting choice of Oculus Studios from
Meta. Their rightful passage.
Turn worlds to ash. You allowed Loki to deceive you. Now his chaos reigns. The universe demands a guardian.
So this is virtual reality.
And with each possession, you will.
I mean, this is going to be interesting to see how well this performs, just because Meta has a track record of
Oh, dutiful
struggling.
Guardian. Here to right your wrongs.
This looks really fun. Holy shit. Fish. A VR headset, maybe not from Oculus.
Your fate is mine.
Ooh, Asgard's Wrath. Asgard's Wrath MetaQuest. It's free when you buy the headset. So interesting.
Foolish mortals, oblivious to the chaos that awaits you just outside. I'll see you sooner than you think.
In Facebook.com.
Lamau. It's been an amazing year, not just for games, but for adaptations of the games we love. Right now, we have an exclusive look at the highly anticipated new series, Fallout.
Fallout.
Oh. Hello there. Now, how about we turn on some lights?
Now, Fallout is a game I do want to play. I've heard so much about Fallout. I don't want to see
tomorrow. Well, you know what they say.
It looks like a movie.
All
the heck?
Never changes.
Fallout.
I don't. The world
from Fallout, please welcome Aaron Moten, Ella Purnell, and Walton Goggins.
And a robot! They literally brought a robot up onto the stage. Let's go.
I hope you don't mind, we brought a little extra security.
Thank you for having us, and we are incredibly excited for you all to see Fallout on Prime this April.
But our real honor tonight is that we're here to hand out the award for Best Adaptation.
Says our bosses are here.
But what?
Oh, there they are.
Oh!
Hey!
God, no, Mr. Howard!
Good catch, buddy.
Yeah, but we should probably hurry this up. I don't think he can breathe in there.
Yeah, how you doing, big man? Okay. All right, let's go.
Okay, so this year, video games and film and television were bigger and better than ever before.
Here are the nominees for Best Adaptation.
Best Adaptation.
The Vampire Messiah will come.
Castlevania Nocturne! Holy shit!
All I ever wanted to do.
I want Castlevania to win.
Your fiance is hope for the world.
Last of Us is also a good contender.
Oh, I got this. No problem.
And
20 years ago, the world fell. That's where the cars and guns come in.
Wow. The best game goes to The Last of Us.
The Last of Us, of course. My dad made me watch an episode of The Last of Us and I was emotionally destroyed. I was destroyed. Both me and my father were destroyed. Dead. Deceased. I wanted Castlevania to win. However, The Last of Us is a really good choice.
All right. Okay, clock's ticking. Shout out to my partner in crime, Craig Mason, who's watching up in Canada, getting ready for season two. Huge thank out to our Naughty Dog family. This wouldn't exist without all your incredible hard work. Big thanks to HBO and the support they've given us. And big thanks to our Last of Us community. None of this exists without you. Thank you so much.
We also want to thank our partners, the Sony Pictures. A special shout out to Carter Swan and the whole PlayStation Productions team and everyone at PlayStation. Thanks so much. Thank you.
Yes. Okay. They must be running tight on a schedule. Think is gonna get game of the year? I'm not sure. I feel like maybe Re4, Resident Evil 4, but I have no idea. It could be Alan Wake. Alan Wake 2 got several awards in several different categories. Yeah, I'm really not sure at this point. It could be Palia. It could be, what the hell is this ad? This is cool.
Yeah.
imagine just killing a big thing. Monster Hunter now, yeah.
When I was younger, struggling with who I was, what my place was, I took a lot of that anxiety and put it into making games. I mean, it's evolved over time, especially as I've gotten into AAA.
Well, guess what, everybody?
Hindsight is a narrative exploration game which spans the life of a woman named Mary. Is taking a core of something that happened in my life, keeping that and fictionalizing the rest of it. Whenever someone tells me that they've cried from something that I've made, it's always when people cry is where I feel, yes, I want to keep doing that. I want to keep making people feel things.
Future Claw.
This negative energy just makes me
2013 was 10 years ago. Oh my goodness. This is a really great trailer, like, to commemorate a long project or a long game, like an evolution. I really like this trailer, like the music in this. Genshin Impact Hoyoverse did win an award, but it was for Honkai Star Rail. It was like... Ooh, are they going to announce
the
award?
That right there was No Man's Sky, a game we announced 10 years ago with this guy right here, Sean Murray. Sean, looks like the content keeps rolling in 2024. But what does the next decade look like for Hello Games?
Well, to start with, next year is going to be a really big year for No Man's Sky. Like you said, I've been working on it for 10 years now, and I still really love it, still really enjoy it. But what people don't know is that for the last 5 years, we've been working on something new.
Another game.
Yeah, something very different, something maybe more ambitious.
Here we go. Tell us a bit about it, Sean.
Well, for No Man's Sky, we generated a whole universe of kind of sparse, alien-looking planets. And that wasn't easy, you know, it was hard, but there is something that's much harder that we wanted to do. For our new game, we wanted to create an Earth, something as varied, a planet that is as varied as a universe, something bigger than Earth, something with mountains, real mountains, not video game mountains, but mountains that are miles high, taller than Everest, that when you climb to the top of them and look out, you can see rivers and canyons and continents. You know, you can see oceans.
So is this like an open world planet kind of thing?
Yeah, I mean, the first real open world, right? Something without boundaries. We're going to let everyone play in it together.
A giant map.
A place where people can live out their sort of adventures together.
No life in that world.
Can't wait to take a look
just
at
no
it.
Just no life in there.
Do you have anything tonight or future? Or?
so we have a trailer.
Oh.
It's quite a small team that's working on it. Yeah. There's about a dozen of us. We're actually, everyone's here. Everyone from the team is here.
Let's go. I'm going to no life in that game. It sounds enormous.
Yeah, we're super nervous, but really excited. If people like it, this is a game I would like to still be updating 10 years from now.
All right, so Game Awards 2033. We'll be back. But no, let's take a look. This is such an incredible project, and I'm honored that we get to show it off. Should we do it, Sean?
Yeah, let's do it.
Here we go.
it's procedural. That's what I thought. I feel like a lot of people are gonna spend their life, like, 10 years in here. I already struggle playing open game worlds. Like, this is gonna be enormous. Oh, look at that! Did say put the whole entire world in a game. Light No Fire. Interesting name. Really interesting name.
Remember, that comes from an independent team. Absolutely incredible. I've been waiting for years to show
That's
that to you. And again, created by the team at Hello Games. So very, very exciting. And I'm excited to see games like that that show kind of the next decade of where games are going to, and hopefully TGA too. All right. Now join me in welcoming to the stage actor Simu Liu.
Wah! He broke
What's
his leg
up,
now!
Everybody, how y'all doing tonight? My God, there's so many of you. You guys all look so beautiful. All right, first off, I want to address the elephant in the room. My foot's fine, you guys. I did tear my Achilles. I wasn't riding a dragon. I was playing pickup basketball in Miami. I wish there were a better story to this, you guys, but the story is this. You know, as you age, as you get older, you know, particularly as you cross the 30 threshold,
oh,
your body
God.
Starts to break down, all right? Things start happening, unless you're Anthony Mackie, for whom I think the laws of aging don't apply. Guys, just if you're not Anthony Mackie, learn to appreciate the importance of stretching, all right? It's very important.
PSA.
Keeping it real at the Game Awards, all right? Now, I'm here to share something that I'm really, really excited about. I recently got a chance to team up with Frost Giant on their new real-time strategy game, Stormgate. Now, RTS is a genre that I was absolutely obsessed with as a kid. I loved building armies and obliterating my enemies in Age of Empires, Command and Conquer, and of course, my absolute all-time favorite game, StarCraft.
StarCraft, yes. I've heard so,
so
much about
So happy you guys
game.
Cheered for that. Now, if you've been destroyed by carriers and void rays on BNet at any point over the past 10 years, that was definitely your boy. And that's why I am so excited for Stormgate. Look, it's a noob strat, I understand, all right? But I loved it. Look, that's why I love Stormgate. It was made by a team of ex-StarCraft developers who are just as obsessed with RTS as I am. And in addition to competitive and co-op modes in the game, it's got an ongoing campaign that was written by Frost Giant with a little help from the legendary Chris Metzen. And so, yes, I brought a little bit of gameplay for y'all and the first reveal of a pretty badass new character who I may or may not have gotten to voice. Let's have a look.
Late, my friend. name have we done?
They've released the bats. I've never played StarCraft, so I'm wondering, like...
See? Pretty good, right?
Interesting.
And now it's time to hand out the next award. Here are the nominees for Best Action-Adventure Game.
Best Action-Adventure Game. Ooh, interesting. Okay. You're the killer. Alan Wake. So many nominations for Alan Wake, dude. This is something else. Same with Spider-Man, dude. We can fight this together! Your soul. Please, Resident Evil 4, win something. How could you let the galaxy fall to this unworthy machine of an empire? Do not look away. You witness a king's revival. The Legend of Zelda might win, though. I'm not sure.
And the Game Award goes to... No surprise here. Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom.
Yeah, Legend of Zelda, I thought so. I really thought Legend of Zelda hadn't had a nomination yet. Yes, Legend of Zelda!
このゲームを作ったすべてのスタッフを代表して、このような賞をいただき、本当にありがとうございます。
I'm so glad to be able to be here to accept this award on behalf of everyone who worked together to create this game.
我々開発チームはこのゲームをゼルダの伝説の中で最も壮大な冒険になるように一生懸命作り込みました。
Everyone on the development team truly gave their all in making this game the best that it could be.
プレイヤーの皆さんそれぞれのユニークなゲームプレイが皆さん独自のハイラルの物語となります。プレイヤーの皆さん本当にありがとうございます。
Everyone's unique approach to playing this game can become their own personal story as an adventure through the lands of Hyrule. And to all the players, you have my sincere thanks.
Thank you so much!
Yes!
Congratulations, Mr. Anuma. And I am happy now to announce winners in a few more categories at the Game Awards. Here are the nominees for Best RPG, Baldur's Gate 3, Final Fantasy 16,
Interesting.
Lies of P, Sea of Stars, and Starfield.
Interesting.
And the Game Award goes to Baldur's Gate 3.
Baldur's Gate!
Here are the nominees for Best Sim Strategy Game, Advance Wars 1 and 2 Reboot Camp,City Skylines 2, Company of Heroes 3, Fire Emblem Engage,
Pikmin 4, come on, Pikmin.
And the Game Award goes to Pikmin 4.
Yes, Pikmin 4.
Here are the nominees for Best Sports Racing Game. EA Sports FC 24, F1 23, Forza Motorsport, Hot Wheels Unleashed 2, Turbocharged, and the Crew Motorfest. And this year, the Game Award goes to...Forza Motorsport. Congratulations, turn 10.
Forza, let's go.
The nominees for best multiplayer this year are Baldur's Gate 3, Diablo 4, Party Animals, Street Fighter 6, and Super Mario Brothers Wonder. And the Game Award goes to Baldur's Gate 3.
Baldur's Gate, yeah.
Have a pretty good night. Here are the nominees for our Player's Voice Award, 100% voted by the
fans. Genshin Impact, Baldur's Gate.
Cyberpunk 2077, Phantom Liberty.Genshin Impact, Marvel's Spider-Man 2,
Ooh.
And The Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. And the Game Award goes to Baldur's Gate 3.
Baldur's Gate keeps winning!
Congratulations, Larian.
Woo!
Let's take a look now at this spectacular celebration of mobile gaming on Sphere from Google and Samsung.
I hope Genshin wins something. They haven't won anything yet. Like, Honkai Star Rail won an award. But not Genshin. Come on, get up! Oh! There we go. There we go. Okay, I'm not sure if these phones are actually like equipped for games. Like if you can actually, like if the battery life is good for gaming. Guilty Gear! Oh my god, Guilty Gear. I actually do want to play some Guilty Gear. What is this? Is this Guilty Gear? Yeah, it's Guilty Gear. I love the art style of Guilty Gear Strive. Also, I don't know his like IRL name, like his actor's name, but like Octopimp voices one of the characters. And Octopimp did a Free/Free. He did an abridged version of Free, 50% off.
そろそろ始めていいか。Player.
Nice. What's this strong block people? Stress meter. I need one of those. Stress City Bar. Addiction can make stress worse. Oh, it's an ad. I thought it was a game. Oh dear. I'm not sure. I think Baldur's Gate 3 will probably win. Alan Wake or Baldur's Gate 3 for Game of the Year. Those are my bets. My third bet would be Resident Evil 4.
All right, welcome back to the Game Awards. We still got some Remake. Awards to hand out. Timothy Chalamet will be here to help. And we have some more
Timothy
world
Chalamet?
Premieres,
really?
Including this one.
What does he have to do with games?
Something's come to my attention, and I'll be damned if I know what to make of it.
It's final, more
some
final
sort of crystal. Enlightened souls forged great and terrible weapons called the Iconoclasts, from which icons derive their name, and turned them against each other in the Magitek War. It seems somebody's woken this place up. The question is.
What the hell is an iconoclastic defense system? I've a feeling we're about to find out. And that we will not like the answer.
Then we'd better cut this short.
Is it too late to get into Final Fantasy?
Welcome, my friends, to Mysidia.
Thank you.
PlayStation.
Experience new adventures before the final battle in Final Fantasy 16 with Echoes of the Fallen, which is out tonight on PlayStation 5.
Nice.
There's a shadow drop for you. Now to present our next award, Best Game Direction, please welcome one of our industry's greatest creative forces, the creator of Call of Duty and global GM for Star Wars Jedi, Battlefield, Titanfall, and Apex Legends, Vince Zampella.
We now know who's responsible for this. And it's him. Hello. Hey, guy. I just told you, guy. Hey, guy.
All right. Good evening, everyone. So, game design can be chaos. Actually, let me rephrase that. The best game design is almost always part chaos, right? Today, it's really normal for teams of hundreds to work for years on huge open worlds that are condensed into one package. When that chaos has somehow been harnessed into a cohesive artistic expression, that's great game design. So tonight, I'm proud to present the nominees for Best Game Direction.
Best Game Direction.
Okay.
How do you run
from Alan Wake with all of the nominations.
Together, we must survive.
This is a tough one.
Be
it's like the same games over and over being nominated. It's interesting.
Link, you are our final hope. You must find me.
Yeah, these it's a Amazing. Tough call between these ones.
And the winner is Alan Wake 2.
It's Alan Wake. I think that Alan Wake is actually going to win Game of the Year. I'm not sure. It's like a tough war between Baldur's Gate and Alan Wake.
Thank you. We want to thank Epic, Hector, Nicole for believing in our vision.
Crazy vision.
Crazy vision, yes. Direction is nothing without a team to actually build it. And huge thanks to Remedy team for joining us on this venture, wanting to believing it and build it. You know, we can pull into different directions and nothing comes out of it. But when more than 100 people believing the same vision and build something out of it, we can make miracles, we can make art, and we can be more than the sum of our parts. Our world today could use a bit more of that.
That's a nice one. One other thing, next Monday, December 11th, New Game Plus, the final draft is going to be coming out. New story content, so yeah. Go play it, thanks.
Thank you. Thank you.
That was a lovely speech, though. That was a lovely speech. I love that speech. I really think that Alan Wake might take the Game of the Year award. Just with the amount of nominations.
Please welcome Gustav Tillaby, the creative director of The Finals.
Gustav?
When we started building this game, we set a bold vision for ourselves. We said that if we're going to make a shooter, it needs to be unique. It needs to be something that no one else is doing. Standing here today, I'm so proud and grateful for the amazing team at Embark Studios who helped make this crazy dream a reality. And of course, to all of you, our amazing players, watching you play the finals has been the most gratifying experience of my entire career. You're not just a part of this journey, you guide us and you inspire us, and I love you for that. Now, let's watch our latest trailer and keep your eyes peeled for the launch date at the very end. It might be sooner than you think. Thank you and enjoy.
Holy. Shit, that looks good. incredible. Valorant and Apex Legends was a mash between, like, get the fuck out, like, GTFO. Well, like, it's got this weird, it's got this weirdness to it that I really like, seeing from this trailer. Plot is, but the visuals just look like the setting and the visuals just look really nice. It's like modern day cowboy gunslinger vibes. The final. Very cool visuals.
That's right, the finals is out tonight on Steam, Xbox Series X and S, and PlayStation 5. After the show, make sure to check out the Game Awards in Fortnite as well. All month, fans have been voting for their favorite user-created island of the year, and the winner is Fort Who. Congratulations. You can portal to the winning island from our TGA map, and while you're there, collect all the TGA trophies for an XP boost. We want to help you unlock those Peter Griffin skins. The island is below.
Oh my god.
The presentation of Game of the Year featuring our orchestral salute to the nominees.
Yes! Finally! Let's see who wins. Oh, I've already said my piece about who might win, who may or may not win. I think it's going to be Alan Wake or either Baldur's Gate. But what do you feel like is gonna win? I'm surprised that Fortnite didn't get many nominations. Like, they did get nominations, but not many. We've got Larian Studios, let's go.
Now, it is time for you to join the others and complete our destiny.
I really like what Larian Studios did for the gaming industry, which was they brought back a complete game. It's not a live service game, it's a complete action RPG.
You'll never want to
leave. Complete game that's been made. And we need to bring that style of games back into the gaming industry. I love the box sets. I love the physical media too. When games make action figures and merch that go with the game, it's nice. I want Baldur's Gate to win. Not only is it a really cool game, just because of it will showcase to the industry that games have to be complete. You can make a fully complete game with no live service bullshit.
All night you've been voting on Twitch for which mobile game you're hyped for in 2024.
Ow!
After the show, check out the TGA post show on Twitch where Google Play will reveal the winner of its Play More award.
Awesome. Thanks, Sydney. Well, now it's time for tonight's final world premiere. That's right, we're getting towards the end of the show, and this one, I will let speak for itself.
Interesting, interesting. We got more dinosaurs. Thank you. XCOM game. Interesting. Monster Hunter Wilds. They have Monster Hunter Now, which was announced, and also Monster Hunter Wilds. What's this about? Okay, another late release. Yes, Capcom.
Please welcome to the stage Monster Hunter series producer Ryozo Tsujimoto. It's so great to have you here at the Game Awards. We got to hang out in Osaka earlier this fall where you showed me the gameplay, you gave me a demo of the game, and wow, I gotta tell you guys, it looks incredible. Everyone wants to know, we saw 2025, when do we get to play this?
はい、ようやく、発表することができました、モンスターハンターの新作です、こちらですね、9月に、ゼフさんにも見ていただきましたタイトルなんですが、現状ですね、2025年、リリースを目指して開発しています。
Thank you, Jeff. I'm very happy to finally be able to announce this title to everyone. This title, back in September, we were happy enough to show it to you. Is planned for release in 2025.
Wow. I think everyone wants to know, when do they get to see more on this? Any sense of when we're going to see more on this game?
はい、こちらのタイトルの 続報はですね、2024年の夏頃、現状予定しておりますので、しばらくちょっとお待ちいただけたと思っております。それとですね、今年、カプコンがですね、40周年を迎えさせていただきました。この40年間、応援してくださった、ファンの皆様、本当にありがとうございます。これからもですね、皆様に楽しんでいただけるいいゲームを、作っていけるよう努力して、頑張ってまいりますので、これからも引き続きぜひよろしくお願いいたします。
We plan on revealing more information about this game in, the summer of 2024, so we hope you keep an eye out for it.
Soon.
Also, Capcom is currently celebrating its 40th anniversary.I would like to thank all of the Capcom fans for all of your love and support throughout all of these years. We couldn't have done it without you. Capcom will continue to create exciting, fun games, and the best is yet to come.
Excellent. Thank you, Ryozo.
Thank you.
Great to see you. All right. Well, now to present Game of the Year,
Woo!
The upcoming films Wonka and Dune Part 2.
Ah,
please
not
welcome
Timothy.
YouTuber Modded Controller 360.
What?I thought it was Timothy Chalamet. It is Timothy Chalamet. What does he have to do with games? I don't understand.
The imagination, passion, and technical brilliance of the six nominees for the Game of the Year were truly inspiring. Here with a medley celebrating each of these games, once again, Lauren Balfe and the Game Awards Orchestra.
Baldur's Gate 3. Super Mario Brothers Wonder. Super Mario Brothers, has been nominated several times. I'd laugh if Super Mario Brothers won. Resident Evil 4! I really want Resident Evil 4 to win, but I think Baldur's Gate and Alan Wake 2 were tight contenders. Legend of Zelda, Tears of the Kingdom. The guy moved from using a flute to a giant flute. Okay, let's go! He's just going ham on the flute. Look at him go. He's the true star of the show. This guy. Not her. Him. Where is he? The guy on the side. Game of the year. Who's gonna win? He put his whole heart and soul into playing that instrument. Now he's back on the smaller flute. All right, who's gonna win? What a marathon of a stream. I've never seen so many games in my life.
And the game of the year is Baldur's Gate 3.
Wow, Baldur's Gate. Baldur's Gate. Baldur's Gate, finally. Look at him, he gets to wear his armor up on the stage. Baldur's Gate, I knew, it was a tight call. I'm glad Baldur's Gate won, holy shit. He's wearing an armor set on there.
I didn't expect it anymore. Thank you so much. A game like Baldur's Gate 3 isn't possible if you don't have an incredible team working on it. And Team Atlarian spent their hearts and souls for 6 years on this game in sometimes very difficult circumstances. This was our COVID game. Along the way, we lost quite a few people also, so we want to dedicate this to all the people we lost, and especially to Jim, our lead cinematic artist, who passed away in the last month.
My God.
I want to thank over 2,000 people, so sit back and relax. But I also want to thank everybody that supported us throughout this entire effort. Our families, our friends, our partners, you were the best, and without you, we couldn't have done it. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. What a well-deserved win. What a well-deserved win. What a well-deserved win. And I hope that influences the game
to all of tonight's winners. We will see you next year at our 10th Anniversary Game Awards, which I'm happy to announce. We'll return right here to the Peacock Theater on Thursday, December 12th, 2024. Happy holidays. Good night.
Happy holidays, everyone. Wow. Whoa. What a marathon. This was a marathon. See you next year, Game Awards. Thank you for letting me co-host, officially co-stream. This will be my last stream in a little bit. This is going to be my last stream. I'm going to go on vacation. I hope everyone enjoyed that official co-stream. Maybe I should co-stream some more things, but I'm going to go. If I don't see anyone before the new year, happy new year. Happy holidays and happy new year. Goodbye, everyone.